Welcome back. In this video, I'll be talking about stacked walls. Stacked walls have been in Revit for a long time. It's not something new, but I think most people underestimate how useful they are. They can be a little bit tricky because it's not really a type of wall, it's a type of types. So it's a combination, it's a combo wall. Okay, so start off with just creating one wall and just make a few copies of that. I'm going to try to do this on interior partition as well on exterior wall so you can see the difference between them, because the interior partition has a certain use case scenario where you have like the partition goes up to the ceiling and then you stop the gypsum wall board and then the stud continues to the structure above. That's the scenario I'm going with for the interior partition 4 7/8. For the exterior wall, I'm choosing a exterior brick on metal stud. Excuse me. No need for those levels. We can hide the levels. And I like to work with shaded since we have some of them have brick on them. This way you can tell which one is the exterior, which one is the interior. For the interior partition, we are going to be modifying its type properties. Make sure that we have thin lines turned on. So this is a metal stud with two layers of gypsum wallboard on each side, or one layer on each side. We'll just go ahead and make a duplicate copy of it. Give it a unique name. For now, we're just going to call it custom. Edit structure. And simply delete the gypsum wallboard on the exterior side, on the interior side. So what is left really is a 3 5/8 metal stud material, nothing else. Okay, so we move now from the interior partition to the exterior wall. We do the same thing. We're going to make a duplicate copy of it, give it a unique name, and figure out what needs to be removed and what needs to stay. Again, we'll just call it custom. Okay, so edit structure. We're now inside the wall layers. We'll delete the brick. We'll go ahead and delete the air layer. And we may leave the membrane, air infiltration barrier, the substrate, the plywood, but we will delete what's on the inside and just keep the stud. 6-inch stud. Okay, so this is I'm adding one layer here, and that is a 2.5 inches material. So the scenario that I'm going with, I'm just making up as a new scenario so you have a good idea what can you do here. Adding a 2.5 inch manufactured stone. I'm just going to use the blue stone that already comes with the project. And that would be just a different thickness, right? So it's a different partition thickness in this wall. So the question is, this looks okay, but how do we put that together, right? In a stacked wall. That's the challenge. Try to move them apart a little bit so I can, so it's easy to work with. Right, so in order to create a stacked wall, I will need a third wall, right? So we have wall number one, wall number two. They are very special, very unique, not like each other, but we need a third wall to select it and then simply use the pull-down menu and select. Change it to a stacked wall. It's a specific type of wall in Revit. The stacked wall in Revit comes with CMU base and a brick top. And there are different thicknesses. That's what the importance of this is that they have different thicknesses. You can do this without the stacked wall, but it's just a little bit more work. It has some pros and cons. It has some advantages to use or not to use a stacked wall. You just have to look at the both conditions. All right, so we have made a new wall type, duplicate copy of the stacked wall, give it a new name, stacked wall 01. Now we're going to look at the edit structure. And in the edit structure, you see that's made up of two wall types. All we have to do now is replace the existing wall types with the new types. So our walls in this case contains the 4 7/8 partition with gypsum wallboard on each side. The top layer or the top wall is the one without the gypsum wallboard. It's just called custom 3 5/8. So this is an interior partition that lends itself more to a situation where you're the gypsum wallboard can stop either at the ceiling level or 6 inches above the ceiling, and then you can attach the wall to the structure above, or have it based on the level. So you just have a little lip there. Okay, that's the interior partition. You may want to change the height of the partition so it's 9 feet. Right now it's just too low. You know, depending on the ceiling can be 9 feet, 10 feet. Or more. So 9 feet is the average, if you will, ceiling height. Okay. Next, let's look at the exterior wall. We'll use the stacked wall again. Again, make a duplicate copy of it and replace its internal wall types to the ones that we just made. So it's a very simple process, and I would say that most people who have been using Revit for a while already know how to do this. But the use case scenario, you know, stick with me for a second. I'm gonna show you a use case scenario where you can add a precast sill to this wall. It is very useful. All right, so the bottom part is a CMU on metal stud. Sorry, it's a brick on metal stud. And the top is the custom wall on a metal stud, which which has a 2.5 inch stone layer. We want to make sure that the studs align with each other, very important. And here it is. Right, so what can you do? So this is a realistic rendering of this. You show the bluestone and the brick. You can clearly see there is a little lip there, little ledge, if you will, which can be modified. Not modified, it can be used for something else. So what would be the most appropriate thing here? You need some kind of sill. So it could be a precast concrete sill or stone or what have you. So Revit comes already with a bunch of precast sills, 5 inch, an 8 inch, 12 inch. So you can just use one of those. So what I'm going to do is edit the upper wall, add a profile, go to sweeps, add a profile, select the 8 inch wide precast sill, set the material to concrete, search for the material by name, CONC. So we'll select the precast concrete precast, verify the look of it, and then set the distance from the exterior part of the wall. So this is more of a trial and error. It's not really, it's hard to get it right the first time. So so I'm gonna go back and modify it and make sure that the offset is, in this case, it's like 1.1 inches to align with the sheathing. Okay, so it sits nicely under the stone, ready to move forward. So it just looks like a little shoe at the bottom, but that's perfect to be on top of the ledge. And here it is, beautiful, you know. So hopefully you can put this to use on your projects, and hope you enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching.